Hello and welcome to my channel. Here we are going to discuss stored procedure in MySQL with input and output parameters. This tutorial includes what is stored procedure in MySQL, why do we need stored procedures, sections of procedure like procedure name, parameters list, SQL codes, types of parameters in stored procedure like in, out and INOUT parameters, how to create a stored procedure, how to list them, how to delete them and how to alter them in MySQL Workbench. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. What is stored procedure in MySQL? Stored procedures are pre-written SQL codes saved inside database and we can reuse them later over and over again using the call statement. So why do we need a stored procedure? Suppose you have to perform some specific task on the database regularly and each task involves multiple SQL codes, you can group SQL codes of these tasks and save it by creating a stored procedure in MySQL. This way you don't need to write same SQL codes every day over and over again. This saves times and also it's fast to execute. Here is an example of a stored procedure in MySQL Workbench. The statements written with orange color are fixed statements, like a stored procedure will start with delimiter and also end with and delimiter. First section after delimiter is create procedure statement, and after this we have to give the name of the procedure, like I have given sales rep. You can change procedure name each time and then two round brackets. Inside these brackets we give the list of parameters, we will learn them in later slides. And second section contains the SQL codes, it start with begin and end with and statements. So between begin and end statements we give all our SQL codes separated by this colon. So this is our first SQL code ending with the colon and this is our second SQL code ending with the colon. There are three sections in procedure: procedure name, parameter list and SQL codes. Statements written with black colors are fixed, I told you this. And after create procedure we gave the name of the procedure. So procedure name comes here and then the parameter list comes between these two brackets and the third section SQL codes comes between begin and end statements. This whole thing, delimiters are used to tell MySQL to mark start and end of entire statement. So you can see the start and end at the end. You can use delimiter as and sign or double forward ticks or $ signs. Like I am using here double and sign, instead you can also use double forward ticks or double dollar signs. Once you create a stored procedure and save it in the database and then you can execute it later using the call statement. So whenever you want to execute you will use the syntax call and after that the name of the procedure. Name of the procedure here sales rep, so call sales rep. Types of parameters in stored procedure, there are three types. First one is in parameter, this is kind of variable and in parameter takes a parameter as input variable to SQL codes. So suppose this is your stored procedure if you are using a variable as in parameter, then you need to give a value to input in this stored procedure. So for in parameter, you need to give a value to input in this stored procedure. Out parameter, it takes a parameter as output variable. Here you don't need to give any value to input in. Instead, it will show you the output as a out parameter. So the last result will be shown as output parameter. There is another in out parameter. It takes a common parameter for input and output both. If you are using a common variable for input and output both, that would be called as in out parameter. So this way you can categorize in out and in out. Let me show you examples one by one how to create a stored procedure using in parameter. Suppose we have a student table which has columns ID, name and grade of the students. So here I have created a stored procedure using in parameters. All the syntax are same. We start with delimiters, end with delimiters, and the first section would have create procedure statement. After that, the procedure name, which is get student data. We need to input the ID value, and the procedure will output the entire data of that student ID. So here we are inputting a student ID. So parameter would be in. So here is a syntax how to list the parameters. The first we have to tell the mod, like if it is in, out or in out. This is the first thing. The second thing, we have to tell the parameter names and then the data type. So here it is in parameter, mod is in, name is stu_id, which is a student ID, and data type is int, which is integer. Between begin and end, we will write our SQL codes. So select star, so it will select all the columns from the student table where id equals stu_id. We have to give the value of stu_id. So whatever value we will give, it will put up equal to ID and then get the data from the student table. So once we create stored procedure, we will save it inside the database, and then we can call this call statement and then the stored procedure name, and inside the bracket, because it is in parameter, we need to give the value, and I have given 102 as a student ID. It will show me the data of student ID 102. If we don't give any value for in parameter, SQL will throw an error saying incorrect number of arguments. How to create a stored procedure using out parameter? So let's see. Here is an example. The whole syntax is same, just we will change the list of parameter here inside the bracket. So here we have same student table, and in the student table, what we are doing, we are counting number of students which got grade as A+. Those are called as toppers, and we will count those IDs and take it out. So that will tell us the number of student which are getting A+, and we will count those numbers. So the name is get topper count. Inside the bracket, mod is out, the name of the parameter is total topper, and obviously it is a number because we are counting the number of students who got A+. So data type will be integer or int. Between begin and end statement, we will write our SQL code. Select count ID into total topper from student where grade equals A plus. Whenever you are using a out parameter, you have to take the output into that out parameter. This is the extra syntax for out parameter. So select count ID, it will count the ID and take it out into total topper parameter. After this, we can save this stored procedure in our database, and whenever we want to execute, we can use the call statement. Here is the syntax to call a out parameter. Actually, there are two lines you have to write here. First, you will use call statement and then the procedure name, and inside the bracket we will not give the value like we gave in the in parameter. Here we are going to write the name of the output parameter, and name is total topper. So at the rate of total topper, and then we will write select statement at the rate of total topper. Once we execute it like this, it will give us this result. This is the name of out parameter, and this is the number of toppers who got A plus. How to create a stored procedure using in out parameter? Here is an example. In case of in out, we are using same variable to input and also take the data out. So same student table we have here with the columns ID, name and grade. So after create procedure statement, the name of the procedure get student ID, and inside the bracket mod of the parameter which is in out, the name of the parameter which is name, and the data type is varchar, and 255 is the size of data type. So this name variable we are going to use to input also, and also taking it out into name variable. So here what we are doing, we will input the student name and it will take out ID of that student. So select ID into names. We are taking the output into the name variable. So output will go into the name variable from a student table where name equals name. So we are also inputting the same variable. So we will give the student name and take out the ID into the name as well. So this is the in out parameter. When we have to execute, as this is in and out both, so first to input we will use this syntax: set statement and at the rate of name equals. So we have given an input value as Rohan, and then these two statements will use for output, like call statement and select statement. Call procedure name, and inside the bracket the same at the rate of name variable, then select at the rate of name. So these two statements to output the data, and this one is to input the value Rohan into at the rate of name. And once we execute it, it will take out the ID of the name Rohan. 102 is the ID of student name Rohan. Let me show you a demo to create a procedure in MySQL Workbench. So I'm going to copy paste this whole code in MySQL Workbench. Here I have copy pasted this. There is a little change. After create procedure statement, we need to write down the name of the database. Like we have database 1 here, and I want to create get student data procedure inside this database 1. So we will write the name as database 1 dot get student data. Rest is same. Let's execute this. It got executed here. You can see the green sign here. Now let's check in database 1. Once you open database 1, you can see tables, views, and this one is stored procedure. Let me refresh this. And inside this stored procedure, we can see get student data, which we have just created. Right click on it. You can create, alter, and drop a stored procedure from here as well. Like if you want to create a procedure, it will give you these statement. You can write down the name here. Inside the brackets, you can list parameters, and between begin and end, you can write the SQL codes and click on apply. Next is how to list stored procedure in MySQL Workbench. To list all the stored procedure in MySQL Workbench, we use show procedure status statement. To list all saved procedure in any particular database, we use the statement show procedure status where db equals database 1. Database 1 is the name of the database for which we want to show the list of procedures. Let me show you in MySQL Workbench. So here we have this statement show procedure status. It will list all the procedure inside this MySQL Workbench irrespective of databases. Database 1 has get student data, Sakila has these four procedure, and then the sys has the rest of them. Now so show procedure status where db equals database 1. Let's execute it. It's showing the only one procedure which database 1 has, get student data, we just created. One more thing, if we want to execute the get student data procedure, we will use the call statement. After that, we need to give the database name dot procedure name, and because get student data has the in parameter, we need to give the value of student id like 102. And once we execute it, it's showing me the whole data of student id 102. If we don't give any value, it will throw me an error, because see here at the last we can see the red sign. It says call database 1 get student data, error code incorrect number of arguments for procedure database 1. Next is how to delete stored procedure in MySQL Workbench. To delete a procedure, we use drop procedure statement. After that, we need to give the procedure name. If procedure does not exist, it might throw an error. So you can use this statement instead to avoid error message. Drop procedure in the square bracket if exist, and then the procedure name. How to alter stored procedure in MySQL Workbench. There is no particular code to alter the stored procedure. We need to go to MySQL Workbench and alter from there. Let me show you. So in this database 1, we have this stored procedure as database 1. Right click on this and we go to alter stored procedure. It will open the window and here we can alter and click on apply. So here we can change or alter name, parameters or SQL codes, and after that we can click on apply. If you have any question, kindly comment in the comment box. If you like this video, please share and like. Thank you. Bye bye.